So, Pap, like we said at the top of this program, lots of news this past week, and you know it is it's fascinating to me. There were two very big stories in, I guess, what we would call in the news media, and I include John Stewart in that, and I'm not sure what that says about the media or what that says about John Stewart. Probably a little bit of both, but the big story, of course, is that NBC has suspended its nightly news anchor, Brian Williams, for 6 months without pay. This is following the revelations of his fake claims as to being shot at by RPGs while in a helicopter.
Well, okay, now, Sam, just so people get this story a little bit clearer. This isn't where there was anything equivocal. It wasn't like, well, gee, maybe I misspoke. If you listen to what he had it down to details. The rocket crashed into the right side of the helicopter. The helicopter went into a spin. The smoke started all around me. I couldn't breathe. You know, there's nothing equivocal about this. And the spooky thing is now you're seeing NBC doing what they're supposed to do, and that's to investigate other stories like that. Look, there's some type – this isn't just a minor issue. First of all, would we ever see Walter Cronkite with a story like this? Would we ever see Huntley Brinkley? Would we ever see Morrow? Of course not. This is a pathology that's a little scary here. This is very scary to me because this is the guy, you know, talking to, you know, 15, 16 million people a night, you know, about what's the news of the day. But this is a pathology. We're not just talking about, gee, I got it wrong. He made up the story. And now it's clear there are other stories he might have been involved with. This is serious stuff, man.
It is. I got to say, though, on some level, like, you know, on one hand, we're talking about the pathology of one guy who is looking back on stories and exaggerating his role for whatever reason. Obviously, he wants it. It makes him feel good to think that he was in that situation. it shows, like, sort of the mentality of what happens when you get embedded in those situations. You begin to identify with the soldiers that you're ostensibly covering.
Yeah, I mean, but Sam, I'd like to be the greatest saxophone player in the world, but I never played with Charlie Parker. You know, I never, you know, that's the equivalent of me saying, and in my mind, you know, Pap, you're really great jazz saxophone. Oh, yeah, well, I played with Charlie Parker. You know, that's how crazy this is.
But now the irony is, of course, you see NBC suspending this guy for 6 months, whereas I want to know about the journalist who was suspended for a day for lying or participating in the lies that got us into Iraq in the first
place.
Very
good point.
You know, I mean, on one level, this is about, you know, this would be the functional equivalent in your story of you saying, not only did I play with Charlie Parker, but when I play the saxophone, I can actually cure polio. I mean, that is, you know, that is a lie that then begins to implicate other people.
Yeah,
and,
okay. But,
and so that's what I just, I mean, yes. And you know, look.
This guy delivered the nightly news, Sam.
Well, that's the other thing.
This is a guy who said, understand, this is a guy with, you remember him with MSNBC? Remember with MSNBC when every night was, oh, my God, I can't believe what Bill Clinton did. This is going to be terrible for my child. This is the image of the president. Don't you remember all this crazy talk?
Uh-huh.
And all of a sudden, next thing, he's anchoring the damn news? Well, he was like a right-wing hack. If you think back, he was MSNBC's right-wing hack. He was there during the time that they got rid of Phil Donahue and they had Mike Savage on the air, and you know, they bring in these right wing hacks. This guy just migrates from there to doing the friggin' nightly news. This is a big story in the sense that how do news people, understand, producers working all around him, how do those producers that are supposed to be the people getting the news not know that the guy that's been on the nightly news for years has been made up this fantasy, pathological lie?
Yeah, I mean, but here's the other part about that that's sort of interesting is that, you know, you said, would Walter Cronkite survive something like this? Of course not. He'd never get himself in that situation. But then when you think about it, I mean, look, right now, Pap, you could hold a gun to my head or you could give me a winning lottery ticket. And in neither one of those situations could I even tell you, who hosts the ABC Nightly News or the CBS Nightly News, nor would I be surprised if you told me they were canceled 15 years ago. I mean, you know, that's the
well,
thing
that's
sort
a different
of
generation,
about.
Though. Okay, that's our generation. We get our news off the internet. Well, I don't watch Nightly News, but there are a bunch of old people around that do watch Nightly News. I'd say I'm not old already.
But part of that is like, you know, there is a posturing of like this guy, and I'm not saying that he shouldn't be suspended. He should be suspended at the very least. But there are
the
more prominent
psychological
lies.
Problems,
yes, it's
Sam.
True.
He needs
but there are more
counseling.
Prominent lies that this media propagates.
Oh, look, hey, how about the lies that? Yeah, the lies that you. Then you're right. The Iraq was. All of them were telling lies. Every yep. single damn one of them on the nightly news was telling a lie. They knew it was a lie. New York Times was telling a lie. But, you know, okay, so we still can't ignore the fact that this guy's got some, man, this guy's got some
It just
some
eats
squirrels.
At me that on some level, this is the way that NBC sort of justifies the other lies. That, you know, this is the way that they basically say, this is how we earn our integrity. To focus only when it's a situation where this guy has a sort of almost like a an individual
well, he's caught.
Pathology.
No. Anytime when he's caught, that's it. The lie is fine until they're caught, until somebody makes a big issue out of it. Otherwise, we're going to let the liars just go continue doing what they do day to day. Now, it is a dysfunctional corporate media. This is no longer a corporate media that looks anything like Huntley and Brinkley or Walter Cronkite. My God, it is something that's barely recognizable as a news source anymore, Sam.
Well, what's ironic is that this happens the same week that John Stewart, and you know, I don't have much to say about it other than it is ironic that it happens the same week where a guy who basically contends that he's hosted a comedy show for the past, I don't know, 15 years or 14 years or whatever it's been, has been the most reliable source of news in our society, particularly to younger people. And so it's
Thank
just
you,
a
Liz Winstead. Yeah.
Right, indeed. I mean, it is Liz Winstead, our former coworker at Air America, one of the founders of The Daily Show. It was pre-John Stewart, but she basically built the foundations of that program. But it is fascinating to see that both these things happen in the same week and to compare and contrast what has become of what was the primary institution, for I guess, keeping people aware and involved as citizens and how that has shifted. I mean, it's just fascinating that the most well-known anchor of network news in the country.
He's a comedian.
Is, well, who it you gets did, sent who, off who, for you, 6 months
did you understand,
in an unpaid suspension, and then the one who's resigning is the one that we almost perceive as the Cronkite.
Well, did you ever do stand-up with John? I know you're a wonderful stand-up comic.
I never did stand-up with him, but back in the day, I knew him and would see him in the clubs, and we'd talk a little bit, particularly about politics, actually.
Well, I want to push you for that show, Sam. You'd be excellent.